Good evening, and welcome to Sacred Heart Convent. Before we begin our time of prayer, I'd like to ask everyone to please silence any electronic devices you may have. And at this time, if you're able, please stand and face the back of the chapel.
God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Sister Mary Gael died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Look kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for our departed servant, Sister Mary Gael, always find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Song of Songs. Arise, my beloved, my beautiful one, and come. For see, the winter is past. The rains are over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth. The time for pruning the vines has come, and the song of the dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines in bloom give forth fragrance. Arise, my beloved, my beautiful one, and come. This is the Lord, the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
my Savior. To you, Lord, I lift my soul. To you, I lift my soul. For the Lord is good and righteous, revealing his way seek him, gently leading the poor and the humble. To you, Lord, I lift my soul. I lift my soul. To the ones who seek
a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on then as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Gospel according to John. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now, remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love each other. The Gospel of the Lord. Sister Mary Gael chose these words for us to hear today. Words I know she contemplated deeply throughout her life and invited others to contemplate. They are at the heart of the final discourse presented in John's Gospel as Jesus' final instructions to his disciples before his death. He speaks to us of new relationships, both with him and with each other. Remain in me, and I in you. I no longer call you servants. Instead, I call you friends. Jesus speaks of a level of mutuality that implies profound trust and deep responsibility on both sides. He embraces equality with us and lifts us into equality with him in sharing fully in his mission. During this Easter season especially, the call to remain reminds me of Mary Magdalene at the tomb. She remained steadfast and loving, both passionate and compassionate, heartbroken yet hopeful, witness to the violence and suffering of the world, and yet clinging to a vision of love and possibility born of her encounter and relationship with Jesus. Her experience of Jesus' love changed her life, changed her very vision of herself. She came to know herself as beloved, and that changes everything. Being loved, knowing it deeply, transforms us. It transforms how we see and hear and perceive everything around us. It becomes our lens, opening us to see and share a love that gives life. I am the vine, and you are the branches. The vine nourishes the branches, which grow to produce leaves and fruit, and also new branches. The very lifeblood of the vine is flowing through us. And just as we are nourished from the vine, we grow and share what we receive. We become ever more vine-like ourselves. Henry Nouwen wrote of the prodigal son, forgiven and nourished again from the vine of the Father, becoming a father himself. Love each other as I have loved you. I think of Mary Gael's relationships with family and friends, all those who loved her so deeply that love transformed her very image of herself. She grew to know herself beloved. And so she loved. Consecrated life was her way of giving her life for her friends. Maybe we should call it consecrated love. That calls us to love broadly and deeply, interculturally and transformatively. Knowing herself deeply loved, Mary Gael reached out in love to family and friends, sisters and students, those she counseled, and those she accompanied in their search for their vocation. And so many of us have grown and flourished in the light of her love. On the day that Mary Gael passed into the fullness of eternal love, I came across a reflection. Becky Hemsley writes from the perspective of a loved one who has died about those sudden moments of emotion welling up when we remember and mourn the one we love. She says, "That's because of our heartstrings. We are connected to everyone we love by invisible, unbreakable threads. And when one of us misses the other person, we only need to pull on those heartstrings to bring them a little bit closer to us. Sometimes it hurts. Sometimes we grab desperately at the thread, like a life buoy in a storm, and our string is pulled so abruptly that it burns, but it never breaks." So I return to that image of Mary outside the tomb on Easter morning, remaining in Jesus' love, steadfast, remembering, pulling those unbreakable heartstrings that bound her to her beloved. She pulled those strings to bring him a little closer, and she heard him call her name once more.
My sisters and brothers, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of God our Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
For Sister Mary Gael, who in baptism received the light of Christ, and through religious profession of vows, intensified her commitment to Christ. May she experience the depths of that relationship forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Sister Mary Gael, who was nourished by the body and blood of Christ, and through her ministry nourished the lives of many others. Welcome her now to the banquet that is the fullness of eternal joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dedicated nursing co-workers and all who cared for Sister Mary Gael, that they may be given the strength to continue their ministry with compassion and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who have been influenced by the deep faith and loving presence of Sister Mary Gael, that we may respond as generously as she, as we await our entrance into eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved sisters who have gone before us to their heavenly home, that their lives give us courage and perseverance in our efforts of preaching for the life of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Sister Mary Gael, the deceased relatives and friends of the Daly family, and the Dominican Sisters of Springfield, that they share in the glory of God's everlasting light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of our salvation, you reward the just and console those who mourn. Hear our prayers in the name of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Pray, my friends, that these our gifts will be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Amen. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, our sister Mary Gael, may be taken up into the glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and with dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things, and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, our Holy Father Dominic, and all the Dominican saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant, Francis our Pope, and Thomas John our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for your own, listen ever so graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, our sister, Mary Gael, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
As we pray these words with our sister, Sister Mary Gael, in this life, we now pray them with her in eternal life. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the risen Christ be with each and every one of you. I invite you to share a sign of peace with one another. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who come to the supper of the Lamb.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant, our sister Mary Gael, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. If you'd please be seated for the remembering.
A spoken rendition of Lord of the Dance. I danced in the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun. And I came down from heaven and I danced on earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth. Dance then wherever you may be. I am Lord of the Dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced for the scribe and the Pharisee, but they would not dance and they wouldn't follow me. I danced for the fishermen, for James and John. They came with me. And the dance went on. Dance then wherever you may be. I am Lord of the Dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on the Sabbath, and I cured the lame. The holy people said it was a shame. They whipped and they stripped and they hung me on high and they left me there on a cross to die. Dance then, wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the Dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be. And I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on a Friday, when the sky turned black. It's hard to dance with the devil on your back. They buried my body and they thought I'd gone. But I am the dance and I still go on. Dance then wherever you may be. I am Lord of the Dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. They cut me down, and I leapt up high. I am the life that'll never, never die. I'll live in you if you'll live in me. I am the Lord of the Dance, said he.
When a popular senior at St. Teresa High School in Decatur with dark flashing eyes told her parents, Tom and Christine Daly, that she was entering the Springfield Dominicans and not the Ursulines, it was the first of many grace surprises that Joanne Christine Daly, our Sister Mary Gael, was to bring to the world who loved her laugh and her dance. An amazing student, Sister Mary Gael was sent after 5 years of primary teaching to study Latin and English, earning her master's degree in the former, to ground 31 years of secondary school teaching and counseling at Marian Catholic and Sacred Heart Academy. She was a life force, the ones alums look to for healing. She remembered them, she loved them, and they knew it. Her creativity had no bounds in the classroom, as I myself, not smart enough to take Latin, found out when I had her for senior religion class. She sent me from the classroom at Marian, telling me to come back and interrupt the class and shout, "I have a message from Paul," and then reading his exhortation to the Philippians to be true in all things. It was the beginning of my own vocation in a setting replete with role models like Sisters Krista, Antoinette, Margaret Rose, Rachel, and Gabriella, who gave us hours after school in listening and support. But I think Sister Mary Gael must have learned those relationships from her siblings, Bill, Mary Catherine, Robert, and Margaret Ellen, for she knew how to make family connections. Not just your Aunt Jo, we all remember her notes, calls, and listening to our own parents, not just when we first entered the community, but with a fidelity of connection throughout the years. Sister Mary Gael spoke of her nieces and nephews with such pride and affection. Knowing families made her an effective counselor and a pastoral minister in her beloved Wisconsin, with deep relationships with adults through her listening. Those first years at Marian weren't always smooth. Sister Gael, always a beloved teacher, returned to Marian when I was principal there for the Founding Four reunion at their invitation, taking special care to heal fractured relationships with alums then in their 50s who still were carrying some hurt. She had a wicked sense of humor. She both entertained and challenged her students and her sisters. We are still searching for her short poem, a poem she wrote at Marian, a convent blessed with a powerful and extremely noisy vacuum cleaning system for floor mops. Sister Gael's poem was entitled "Ode to the Celibate at the Vacuum Slot." It began, "Hail to thee, O neat and tidy," and ended with a lampoon of the early riser bringing us all with her every Saturday morning. The mistress of irony, she had the soul of a poet in a very deep package, brightly making connections that were intuitive, inviting to beauty. Contemplative, she could sit with hours with art and a poem, only to emerge to re-engage, sparkling with all she met. With a laugh, and what a laugh, she would have had having her picture last at our chapter remembrance of our deceased last week. "Ha," she'd say, "Gotcha. Out of smilance, I smile." Going beyond the Daly side, I think Gael drew on her mom's heritage of knowing exactly what she wanted in most things. Sister Theodora recalls Gael telling her once that her mom tethered her to a backyard tree when she was a bit the wild child. When Gael asked me to take part in this farewell, she refused stubbornly to even tell me anything she wanted. On the other hand, the last time she spoke to me in February, she confirmed her drink preference for the heavenly banquet, loudly proclaiming, "Scotch!" among the pro-offered beverage choices on at least three separate visits. That same strong spirit, the support of her nieces and the sisters here, helped her to recover parts of herself after that catastrophic stroke and fall. The lovely woman, so light on her feet, had to run only in spirit and find again the meaning of the art and contemplation that she loved. If you knew Gael, you know she found garden art in all beauty in deep relationships. Gael was simply, as my mom would say, elegant. And she favored all things elegant. She said this virgin was from Vietnam, and she gave it to me for my final profession and told me I was not to give it away, at least in her sight. I have carried this elegant stone with me for years in pride of place, and now I return it to you, her family, with all the love we have, knowing that your dear sister, your Aunt Jo, is listening to the music, enjoying a fine single malt scotch, dancing and arranging the flowers and wall art at the heavenly banquet. For I can say to you, Sister Mary Gael, what you put in my hands at age 17. Mary Gael, I have a message from Paul. Whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, is now yours forever.
If possible, I invite you to stand. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister, Sister Mary Gael. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Thank you.
Into your hands, God of mercies, we commend our sister, Sister Mary Gael. In the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful God, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Sister Mary Gael, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. The Lord be with you. Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful God, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Amen.